Hi, welcome to Let's Play Guitar. Today we are learning how to play Everything Has Changed by Taylor Swift and Ed Sheeran. So you can check out more songs that I've done for Taylor Swift and Ed Sheeran. I've got the complete playlist for that. The links are in the description box below. And don't forget to check out my Facebook page as well. You can request me a song, and I also update you with my upcoming tutorials or on Facebook. Okay, so let's get into this one. You need a capo on the 2nd fret to match it with the original track. Now if you put the capo on the 4th fret, you don't need all those bar chords that I was playing, okay? So mainly my idea of teaching this song is to help you with bar chords, because it's a great song to practice your bar chords, your B major or your C sharp minor. But I'll also be showing you the chords when you put the capo on the 4th fret. It becomes a lot easier, okay? So let's see the chords that you will need when we are putting the capo on the 2nd fret. The first one we're using is E major. Right, 2nd fret, 2nd fret, 3rd fret. The next chord that we're using is C sharp minor. Okay, we're using this chord. Then we're using a B major chord. Right, and then an A major chord. We're also going to use an F sharp minor chord. So the bar chord over there. Okay, so those are the chords that we're going to use in this lesson, since we're doing this with the capo on the 2nd fret. Now, if you put the capo on the 4th fret, instead of E major, you're going to use a D major. Alright, and instead of a C sharp minor, we're going to use a B minor chord. It's the same shape, it's in the same position, but if you take this as a nut, then you know, you can call this a B minor. After that, we're going to use A major, okay, instead of the B that we were using over there. And instead of the A that we were using over here, we're going to use a G major chord. Or like this, where you like it. And then we're also going to use, when we were using our F sharp minor, you're going to be using an E minor chord. So as you can tell, we're not using any bar chords over here, okay? All are very easy chords, except for the B minor, which you can also play this way. Now that you know the chords that I'll be using, we're gonna play this song and learn this song with on the 2nd fret, okay? And we're gonna learn the strumming as well, everything on the 2nd fret, so you can, you know, replace the chords with what I just told you. If you wanna make it simple and follow my strumming pattern, that will remain the same, whether or not you have a capo anywhere, okay? All right, let's see how to play the beginning of the song, the intro, and this also comes after the chorus. Okay, so that's this. Okay, that's the little intro. Now let's learn the strumming pattern over here. What you're doing is, that's the basic strumming pattern. Then you want to keep repeating it, okay? So you repeat it again, right? Repeat. Repeat. Okay, now let's break it down. What you're doing is, you're doing down, 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 up, down, up. That's the first part of the strumming pattern. The first downstroke is on the bass strings. So for example, for the E major, you have it on the bass, we'll take it from the 6th string, right? Then the next downstroke is on the lower strings. So down, 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 up. That's the first part of the strumming pattern. Down, down, up, on the E major, right? Once again. Then the next part is where we put our pinky finger on the 2nd fret of the 3rd string. So that way you'll have 2nd fret over here, 2nd fret over here, and 2nd fret over here, right? So you want to keep this shape as it is on the E major. You just want to add your pinky over here on the 2nd fret of the 3rd string to make the change over there. Alright, so let's see what's happening over there. So from the beginning we had down, 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 up, down, up. Now what we do is down, up, down, up, down, up. Okay, so that's three down ups. On the first down up, you don't put the finger over here. The first down up is on E major, down up. Then on the next two down ups, you keep your, bring your ring finger in. So down up. So as soon as you do the up stroke, you get your finger over here on the second fret, okay? Your pinky finger. So down, up, So when you're doing the up stroke, you want to make sure you get this note over here on the third string, because if you focus on the other strings, then you won't get this why we are bringing our pinky over here, okay? So you want to make sure you focus over here when you do the up stroke. So down, up, and then down, up. Okay? So if we now combine the first part and the second part of the strumming pattern that we learned, the first part was completely on E major. It goes like this, down, up. And the second part was down, up. So if you put that two parts together, you get down, up. You get it? Okay, so now I'll say the whole strumming pattern. And then what you want to do is you want to keep repeating it. Okay, so that's your basic strumming pattern. For the very beginning of the song, you just want to do it two times, and then you start singing the verse. Okay, so down, up, and you do it one more time. Down. Okay, so it might look quite fast because when you go with the actual tempo of the song, that way it becomes quite fast, the change over here. So what you want to do is you want to practice it really slowly, and then slowly you can bring it up to the actual speed of the song. So it's down, right? Okay, so in the very beginning of the song, you just want to do it two times. So that will be down, up again. And then you start singing. Then the strumming pattern actually changes. When you start singing, the strumming pattern changes. Okay, that little part that I showed you, for which we took a lot of time to learn this. A beginning strumming pattern on the E major is just for the beginning opening of this song, which is played two times, and this also comes after the chorus. Okay, when you start singing, the strumming pattern becomes a little easier. Okay, so what we're doing over there is what we're doing is you start on the E major and you do down, up. Okay, so it's down, up, down, up, down, down, and in the end, the down up is the transition to the next point. So the down up will be can be on the C major, C sharp minor, sorry. So down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, down. Then you want to make sure the next downstroke falls on the C sharp minor chord. Okay, so down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down, up. Move A major. Down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. The next downstroke shall fall on the B major chord. Okay, so from the beginning, if we start from the very beginning of the song, let's start with the strumming pattern that we learned in the very beginning. Down. Then go. Down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, up, down, 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 down Okay? Now, what Ed Sheeran does is he stops in the middle on the B chord. He goes like this. If I start from the beginning. Right? Down, down, up, down, up, down, down. C sharp minor. Down, up, down, up, down, down. A major. Down, up, down, up, down, down. He stops on B chord like this. Okay, so what you want to do is on B chord, you just want to do a single down stroke. And then with the left hand, you relax your fingers a little to mute the sound. Okay? Because those lyrics go like this. If I start from the verse over there. See what I mean? So, down. Start again. Down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, down. Up, down, up, down, 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 up, A major. Up, down, up, down, 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 up, B major. Now you do it. Down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. And then you go to the pre-chorus of the song. So the pre-chorus goes like this. That's the pre-chorus, and you repeat these lines one more time. So we start on E major chord for the pre-chorus. Okay, you do the same strumming pattern, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Okay, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Move to F sharp minor chord. So, next down stroke should come on F sharp minor chord. Down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Next down stroke should come on A major chord. Down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. And then B major. Down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Now there's another way that Ed Sheeran plays these chords. You know, you can do it like this. You can leave the second string open. Make it simple. Similarly for B major. Sounds nice. What you can do is 2nd fret, 4th fret, and 4th fret. Leave these two strings open, right? So anyways, for the pre-chorus, down. This one, you better know. F sharp minor, down. You better know, down. This one, you do. Up, down, up, down, 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 again. This one, chorus. All I know is say hello. The strumming pattern is the same for the chorus as well. It goes something like this. You start with the E major chord, right? All I know is say hello. C sharp minor. Down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. B major now. Down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. A. Down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Again. First we held the door. You'll be mine and I'll be yours. Up, down, up, down, 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 down. Thing has changed. So what you want to do is from B major to A major, you go down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. And just simple down strum on the A major and you let it ring. Okay, so or you can do down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Thing has changed. Leave the B string open, right? Then you go back to the intro that I taught you. There's another variation in the very end which goes like this. This. That's the variation. What I'm doing over here is do a hammer-on from the first fret to the second fret on the third string. Then the second string and first string open. So, and then the second string again, so, okay. okay? And then again the third string, second fret, and then the third string, first fret. So it goes, okay? And then you start on the second verse, okay? On my walls, A major, down, 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 down. Then the whole thing, the whole verse. Then you got the whole pre-chorus thing, then you got the whole chorus one more time, and then you got the bridge of the song. So the bridge goes something like this. Start on C minor, C sharp minor chord. And we're gonna do the same strumming pattern, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Okay? So it goes like this. Come back and tell me why. A major. Feeling like I've missed you. E major. All this time. B major. Repeat it again. E major, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, E major, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. And then you go to the B chord, just strum once over there. So from E major, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Okay, and then you go to the pre-chorus. So again, the bridge, C sharp minor. Down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, A. And then you go to the pre-chorus again. Now what you want to do is, after this bridge, when you go to the pre-chorus, you want to do palm muting over there. So you just put your palm just where the strings begin over here, okay, just where the bridge, and then you start strumming. So you get this muted sound over there. And then you strum the same strumming pattern that we've been using for all the pre-chorus. So E major. Sharp minor, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. You know you can do continuous down strokes in the B chord because then you're moving to the chorus again. All I know is we said hello. Sharp minor, B, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. Everything has changed and all I know is we held the door. So you want to stop on A major in the end, okay? So from B major, down, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, down. Everything has changed. All right, and that marks the end of this beautiful song. So that is it, guys, for this lesson. I hope you liked it. And if you did enjoy this lesson, then please make sure to give this video a like. I appreciate all of your support. And make sure to go to my channel and subscribe, because you'll be getting more Ed Sheeran songs, more Taylor Swift songs, and more easy song lessons that you can play easily, all right? And I'll be seeing you guys next time. Make sure to visit my Facebook page and stay updated on that. So I'll talk to you guys next time. Till then, goodbye.